D-Y-L-A-S.
Yeah, what's your last name, though?
Henderson.
Common spelling? So, you're in 7th grade, right?
Mm-hmm.
So tell me a little bit about what you guys have been talking about today.
Well, we've been talking about, peace, promoting peace, peace with other countries and peoples and worlds. And, we've had the, people from, students from Rebecca College coming in and talking to us.
So what have they been talking to you about? Have you learned anything interesting?
I learned that they don't have Star Wars in Saudi Arabia.
That is awful.
It's quite a shame, but, you know.
Why do you think they don't have Star Wars in Saudi Arabia?
It's an American film franchise?
Do you think it has to do with anything with the fact that there's violence in it?
Well, there's plenty of things. Say if there's there's plenty of things you can do. There's you can always petitions, you can take part in some organizations that support peace.
Thank you, Dylan. I appreciate it. So, your turn. I love your necklace. So, same thing with him. Can I get you to say and spell your name?
Maya, M-A-Y-N.
And you're also in 7th grade?
Yes, I am.
So, one of the teachers mentioned you guys are doing testimonials. Have you done that yet? Testimonials? Yeah, about peace.
Yes, well, this week at school is Peace Week, and in drama class, what we've been doing is writing monologues about peace, and we're going to present them on Friday.
Have you written your monologue yet?
Yes, I have.
Can you read it to me?
Yes, of course.
You got to be dramatic, though.
Yes.
Okay.
Middle school is such a pain. Now I understand exactly why my mother moved to after father died. Coming from a foreign country, India, it's hard to fit in around here in America. And Miss Dover has made that clear state. Sure, I may not have the best reputation, but I'm still a person. I have feelings too. Miss Dover talked to me slowly, and I quote, "Sarah, this is a classroom. Have you ever heard of a classroom? These here are students, and I'm a teacher." These were her exact words. Does it look like I've been raised by animals or haven't been part of civilization? It hurt. Teachers don't understand. Making me more fierce and sad. I was just absolutely appalled and not used to this type of environment. Middle school is just great. So I got through half of the year, wanting to go back to India, a place I knew and loved. Yet, I started questioning myself whether or not I was doing something wrong. I began to wonder. I thought about how mother has the strength to give everything a second chance, and not to judge everything all at once. To be patient and to find peace within. Although, I never really took that principle into consideration. Until now. Instead of being negative, I thought about the positive and what I could do to make a change. What if I incorporate my life here in India and my life here together? And that's exactly what I did. I wrote an essay about India and my life here in America, so Miss Dover could get to know me. I talked about how we should accept each other's differences because in the long run, we're all the same, right? And I realized that peace is about being able to keep an open mind, right? And most importantly, to think about others and where we come from. I think when my first day in middle school, I realized that it was just a bad foggy memory that I never really cared to revisit. Oh, and remember, even when times are rough, if you keep positive and think about peace within, peace will come to find you. And I guess that was the answer all along.